together through basic materials, wrote as a basic material project. Okay, we're on episode 14 of the podcast, and today's podcast we're using Adobe Audition, part of the Adobe Creative Cloud, which is, you know, you pay whatever, £50 a month, £40-£50 a month, to get to use the whole Adobe tool, which we spent a few hours on. I figured out how it all works. So we're just going to try out this Adobe Audition software to do the podcast. It looks pretty decent. It's actually very beady-eyed to use Adobe products. It's quite fantastic. We've had a go of the whole range of products. Ableton, of course, at the top of the stack. Can't forget Ableton, right? Adobe Acrobat DC, Adobe Acrobat Distiller, Adobe After Effects. We've done a little test on that Adobe After Effects, doing a little tutorial. Adobe Animate, we've had a look at that, it's pretty funny. Adobe Audition, what we use to record podcast. Bridge, Character Animator, the Creative Cloud, Dreamweaver, Soft Website, Illustrator, Graphics, InCopy, and InDesign. I think they're for print, doing the DPI printouts, like for leaflets, posters, works of art, and what have you. Adobe Lightroom, we've never used that. Adobe Lightroom Classic. Adobe Medium Pro is cool. We mentioned that previously at the podcast, maybe last year sometime. Adobe Medium Pro is where it's at. That's really what does all the work. Photoshop. I've never really used Photoshop before. What's Photoshop? It says Premiere Pro is for film. Right, and you combine, you do Premiere Pro, and then you go to this Adobe After Effects, put on text and titles on it, and what have you. Premiere Rush is like a bit of a handheld stuff, and this Adobe XD. I'm well impressed with this Adobe XD. It's probably why your websites, if you look at people's websites, like, I think the difference is Adobe products, basically. That's a lot of money over the life cycle of a website. For example, to run the basic materials projects over 2 years, like, would be about £2,800. I still is realistically how much it would cost, including the Adobe tools. But absolutely fantastic, we do everything. Obviously, it's still back on the Windows 10, so we're not on the. Just to clear things up, we're not on the Linux Fedora workstation server combo. We're going to get to that in a bit when we rig up Adobe Dreamweaver. And we can show how you run websites, basically a server form or a web form using Adobe products. So, what we're going to do with Adobe Dreamweaver is we're going to link it into the. Obviously, carrying on from the C++ ASAP series and. The Linux Fedora workstation 35, and we use the virtual machine, the boxes on the to load up a Linux Fedora server. Okay, so after configuring that Linux Fedora server in there on that AMD box, we're back on the Intel box now with the Windows 10. Just to be sure, yeah. But because obviously the PCs are side by side, and we've got a network switch as well. We make sure you have to bring on the network switch to do this, like a little router or what have you. Right, okay, so we're going to use Adobe Dreamweaver, and what we're going to do is we're going to configure Adobe Dreamweaver to find the Linux Fedora server on the local internal network, or the local office network, or what have you. And then we'll see how, using the Adobe Toolkit, we can put our website, so we can now create online as Apache, MySQL, PHP, etc. We can now use the Adobe tool to deploy websites, lots and lots and lots of websites. You can easily manage individually, say over a year or two. You could easily manage 60 or 70 different websites with these tools individually. That's why I have this, we'll get to demonstrating. So why do we even bother with that all Linux Fedora detail? But so what we'll do is we'll demonstrate using Adobe Dreamweaver to attach into a server, which is like, for example, if you're a web developer or web designer, you want to, for your clients, you'll show how you can manage many websites using the Adobe Toolkit and the Adobe Creative Cloud. Yeah, it's expensive, and it's expected to pay about £2,800 over 2 years, and you need a pretty decent computer or what have you. But now, so what's the commercial intent or the business reason behind this? Well, we've kind of got our little technology in play now. We have our Windows 10 operating system, we've got our Adobe Creative Cloud on the one hand, and on the other hand, we have that's all right. But it's an AMD chip, AMD 3000DS, the cheapest PC in the UK. Refer back to the previous replacements that we've got there with the dot. And that's on Linux Fedora Workstation 35. And also, it's got virtual machine of a Linux Fedora server. Okay, so the Windows 10 box joins the Linux Fedora server, basically. And using the Adobe tools on the Windows box, it's a Windows box with an Intel chip. It's funny how it's split down the side. I think we have AMD on it with a Linux on the one hand, and we have a Windows with an Intel on the other. Right, so best of both worlds, open source, paid for. And you see how, like, for example, in the paid for world, we did do Windows Server 22. We tried getting it going, but we failed on that one. But obviously, in the paid for world, commercially, you're expecting results in as near to real time as possible, where it's managed and economical and all that, and what have you. Whereas the Linux open source world, we talked about previous slides, left brain and right brain sort of development schemas, what have you. But anyway, give her in, we'll get back to the main point. So, yeah, Adobe, and it's all sorts of anime and what have you. It's Adobe XD is fantastic. The dog with the mobile phones and tablets. We've had a dabble of, I'll find it now, putting onto the mobile phone handset and the tablet, the Adobe suite of apps as well. So, with a Creative Cloud membership, you get to share everything from your mobile phone. So, every time you take a photograph, or every time you take a video, or every time you have it. I don't think Adobe Audition is available for it on mobile yet, but it should be, because if we remember back in the original Base Materials podcast, we were doing it on a mobile phone with hands-free kit using the SoundCloud app. But of course, SoundCloud's update took away the podcast feature. So we started out with Audacity and SoundCloud app on a mobile phone or tablet, and just using the Audacity software through Graphic EQ and Amp. And the compressor limiter, there's those three little production steps that sounded great. So, we've ended up a year later on Adobe Creative Cloud with the network server, as well as for 1 and 2. So, now obviously, we're recording using this with Adobe Audition. This Adobe XD is fantastic, it means you can beam your website to your mobile phone handset or your tablet, and it's much more pleasant. The pleasantness is it's got up. It's easy to do. Obviously, we're cold here, so we've not really been using productivity enhancing tools. So really, to get it going in real time, all the time, the results of course are as fast as possible, industry standard and that. Forced onto a Windows box, the Adobe, it feels like the nag about open source, and how it's a superior moral position, right? But it's also like pain. Again, we're getting off topic, really. So, once we've got this next project out of the way, this is now so next. Project is to blend back the Adobe Dreamweaver, and we're going to attach it onto the Linux Fedora server. If you're wondering, there's a virtual machine in the AMD box that's also on Linux Fedora Workstation 35, and obviously we have a network switch as well. So we'll get that configured next, and then we'll demonstrate how we can have many, many websites. And because it's on a Linux server, it's going to have a domain name system and active directory and all of that. means like stay within the whole network segment, whatever your website address is, you can create a little DNS pack. We're going into the Bramwell, but it's why it's admin on that line, but hopefully you get to see, and especially when you get to see this, you can perhaps also see that, well, what if you're working as part of a development team? There's going to be realistically maybe 20, 30, 40, including attempts, maybe 50 people using the Adobe Creative Cloud. And you've got to see how that connects to the web servers and such like. So, for example, you can go to your web hoster and you can get your entry-level web hosting for cheap if you do it all yourself. Or you can pay big bucks and get a whole team doing it absolutely fantastic all across the board, from business cards to, you know, whatever labels and pamphlets, what have you, and what kind of posters and stuff like that. The adult is very engaging, it's very, very rich. The pleasantness is increased much as regards. So it's almost kind of feel sorry for people that don't. There's just, I don't know if it's a creativity thing or what have you. But yeah, I'd say the Adobe has definitely got that together. Definitely. But to fully exploit the whole toolkit, you get a lot for your money. I've looked actually here. So we've got a bunch installed, and we've got the Adobe Creative Cloud. Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff. Yeah, including some camera stuff as well, too, with the data formats. I think that's Canon data format there. I think I've got the industry in on it, something like that. There's a couple of little 3D things in beta, you know, to try it out. Oh, yeah, and we had a deal on the... portable stuff, the handheld stuff, and we've got a few 3D sort of things going on, a few materials, objects and stuff like that, using the mobile phone and the tablet, which synced back to cloud, so it was available at the desktop, so we could go further. We did a few things live. For example, we've got a few documentations or whatever that and use the Adobe scan, and whatever is so. And it can be, you know, you can scan your documents and combine it together in an Adobe document format. It's quite fantastic, really. And you obviously you can have a mess around with the faders and get a few different effects. Alright, so we'll leave it there for now. We'll get back to where it was. What we've got to do is link the Adobe Dreamweaver to the dummy server. That's also what I say. So now we did the tangent project on the Linux Fedora sort of thing. We can merge the projects and bring them back together again by linking up the workstation computer to the dummy server or the project server. And then I've got obviously got some bramble buses of Linux shells and shit coming up. So maybe we're not even going to mention it. I'll cut that shit out. Like, it's a pain. But we can get there with this login thing and we'll then get the dummy server and we'll pump the dummy server to the web form so that will be generally accepted public internet. So we'll show how after achieving this next step, because there's a further step ahead. Alright. Anyway, once again, best into the project. Like and subscribe. Very kind of you if you would. And alright, until next time.